Hi, if God told you you could have anything you want, what would you ask God for? Well, God did that to a man in the Bible by the name of King Solomon. Let's listen to the story and see what he asked God for.
David was very old. He had been king of Israel for 40 years. He had been a good king who tried to serve God. Even when he made mistakes, David was always sorry and tried to do better. The Lord knew that David had a good heart. David was about to die. He told his son Solomon to be the new king. Always follow the Lord, Solomon. Obey his commands, David told his son, and then David died. When Solomon became king, he prayed to God and said, "Oh Lord, I want to be a good king. I want to serve the people and help them. Please give me a wise heart so that I can always tell the difference between right and wrong. Help me to be a wise king for the people." God answered Solomon's prayer. Solomon became known everywhere as a very wise ruler. He was also very rich and famous. People came from everywhere to talk to wise King Solomon. They would tell Solomon their problems and he would give them wise advice to help them. Once, there were two women who lived in the same house. Each woman had a baby of her own, and at night the babies would fall asleep in the same bed with their mothers. One night, while the women were sleeping, the first woman accidentally rolled over on top of her baby. Sadly, her baby died. The woman wanted a baby so much that she decided to take someone else's baby. She quietly snuck into the second woman's room and switched the babies. When the second mother woke up, she found the baby dead beside her in the bed. At first, she thought it was her baby that was dead, but then she realized that she had been tricked. She wanted her baby back. The two women went to King Solomon. The second woman told him what had happened. She said, "It is my baby. I want my baby back." The other mother said, "No, it is my baby. You can't have it." Everyone looked at Solomon. How could he ever know which woman the baby belonged to? But remember, God gave Solomon special wisdom. Because Solomon was wise, he had an idea for finding out the truth. He ordered one of his servants to bring him a sword. Then Solomon said, "I order that the baby be cut in half with this sword." The first woman said, "Okay, that's fair. The baby should be cut in half. That way neither of us will have more than the other." But the other woman looked very sad. "No, do not cut the baby in half. I love the baby too much to see it hurt. I would rather the other woman have my baby. I do not want my baby to die." Solomon had done a very wise thing. Now he knew which one of these was the real mother and which was not. A mother loves her baby very much and would never want it hurt. Solomon gave the baby to its true woman. Everyone saw that Solomon really was wise. Everyone knew that God had given him special wisdom.
Wow, isn't that amazing? He could have asked God for anything, but he asked for wisdom. What is wisdom? Wisdom is God's answers to our problems. Wisdom is God's answers to our problems. So whatever problem you may face, you may have problems with math, may have problems with reading. All we have to do is ask God for wisdom, and he will always give us what we need. So matter of fact, that is our chant for today. If you need wisdom, just, and you're going to say, ask God. I'm going to say, if you need wisdom, just, and you're going to say, ask God. Let's try it. If you need wisdom, just, if you need wisdom, just, and that is true. If we ever need wisdom, all we have to do is ask God. He will give us the answers to all of our problems. Have a great day and pray for wisdom. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.